championship belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. Russell Westbrook coming into town, and now it's on Rob Pelinka and the Lakers front office to build out the rest of the squad. They are already being connected to a few veteran names. Joining me to help break it down is Ron Gutterman from LakersNation.com. Ron, how are you doing, man? And the Lakers, look, have a tall task to build a team around now a big three of Westbrook, LeBron, and Anthony Davis.
Yeah, and the needs are clear. Shooting and wing defense. Yep. That's essentially it. You know, you have 10 open roster spots if you include Marc Gasol and Alphonso McKinney as a part of the Lakers roster. You have 10 open roster spots, and I wouldn't be surprised if 8 or 9 of those guys were shooters and wing defenders.
Absolutely. I do think that Caruso and THT ultimately get brought back. We'll see how they fit into that mix there as well. But, you know, you need shooting. You need wing defenders. But fortunately, we've been hearing for a little while, now, maybe a couple of weeks, that the Lakers, should they do something big, we're going to have a line of veteran free agents willing to take the veteran minimum to play for the Lakers. And I think Russell Westbrook certainly counts as doing something big. And so far, we're already hearing a couple of names connected to the Lakers, according to Jake Fisher of Bleacher Report, Carmelo Anthony, and Rudy Gay. What do you think about those targets?
I mean, look, they're both cheap. I imagine they're both veteran minimum guys. Rudy Gay, you know, at one point in his career, commanded more. But I think he's a veteran minimum guy now. Maybe I'm wrong. I think it's low risk and pretty high reward moves. I mean, they both shoot the ball relatively well. They're, you know, Rudy Gay's coming off a season where he shot 38% from three for the Spurs. And that's a team that had a lot of spacing issues. So for him to do that is impressive. And then Carmelo Anthony is just, I mean, he's a known scorer. Obviously, he's not what he once was, but in a limited role, he can still really provide positive stuff for your team, even though, again, he's not what he once was, and it needs to be in a limited role.
I think either one of these guys is an intriguing option. In fact, both of them actually could fit on this Lakers squad. I think with Kyle Kuzma gone, that's where this really opens the door for a Carmelo Anthony, for Rudy Gay to come in and be that power forward coming off the bench and provide a little bit of a scoring punch with the Lakers' second unit. That was kind of going to be Kyle Kuzma's role for a little bit, although, frankly, his role changed a ton over the years. But you could see where the Lakers could need something like that. Particularly, I really like that, especially Carmelo Anthony, but both of these guys really can knock in free throws at a fairly high rate. Carmelo especially, but these are guys where if you put them on the floor late in the game and they get fouled, they can definitely help you out there. They're the kind of guy that can get to the rim, draw a little bit of contact, and then sink their free throws. And that can be so important down the stretch in games. Plus, they're pretty good in terms of floor spacing. My question is, and maybe this differentiates the two a little bit, defensively, can either one of these guys hold up on the defensive end of the floor right now? I don't think at, 35 and 37, either one of them are going to be looked at as defensive stoppers in any way.
No, and Carmelo Anthony, you know, his role in Portland with the Trailblazers, he was kind of just a bigger wing body. He wasn't going to stop anybody, but he was going to provide some resistance when you're going up against, you know, your Kawhi Leonards and your star wings. He wasn't going to stop anybody, but he was going to provide resistance. And same goes for Rudy Gay. You know, he's a little bit better of a defender than Carmelo Anthony. But yeah, there's issues. There's concerns about their age. But if you think about last year's Lakers team, when they were playing Kawhi Leonard, when they were playing Paul George, when they were playing some of the better wings, the star wings, Kevin Durant, KCP was asked to do that a lot. Kuzma was asked to do that a lot. And so if you're switching from KCP and Kuzma to, let's say, Rudy Gay and Carmelo Anthony, you know, Kuzma and KCP are better defenders, but Rudy Gay and Carmelo Anthony are bigger and provide a little bit more strength. So I'm not sure the drop-off is too significant, even though it is less. I'm not trying to say it's the same. It's worse.
Can either one of these guys be the three, or are they both pretty much stuck as being backup fours at this point? I mean, they were both threes initially coming into the NBA, but obviously as players age, they tend to move down a position. Do you see them as exclusively fours? Because I think that might matter when we're looking at how the Lakers build out their roster from here.
Yeah, I think Rudy Gay is for sure a backup four. He's not a three. Carmelo, he can reasonably play the three still. Maybe not against, let's say, Brooklyn. Yeah. Maybe not against.
He's not defending the quicker guys.
Yeah, against the quicker teams, but against a decent amount of NBA teams, you could reasonably put Carmelo at the three. I wouldn't start him by any. Neither of these guys are starters, but they could provide reasonable punch off the bench. You know, Melo, your three, Rudy, your four, and then you get Gasol or some other center you sign in free agency to be your five.
I guess here's really the great thing about where the Lakers are at right now. We've talked a ton about the hard cap and how difficult it is to build out a team. It's out the window. The Lakers are not going to trigger a hard cap. They essentially can't fill out a roster if they trigger a hard cap at this point because they took back salary in the Russell Westbrook trade, which, okay, that's fine. Now we know. We know they're not triggering a hard cap. And why that's a good thing is because if you sign a guy to a veteran minimum contract, a one-year deal, veteran minimum, and things just don't work. Carmelo Anthony, let's say you sign Carmelo Anthony, which I like. I'm totally for, totally in support. But let's say it goes the wrong way and just isn't working. You cut them and you sign somebody else for the veteran minimum. It's not a big deal. You can continue to stack up those veteran minimum contracts as long as you're willing to keep paying. And the Lakers have pretty much shown that they're going to pay whatever it takes to help LeBron James win another championship and bring home number 18. So I think it's a very low risk move because, again, if it doesn't work, you can move on from these guys and just sign someone else with a veteran minimum. It's not like you have to worry about hitting a ceiling or anything like that.
Yeah, with a hard cap, veteran minimum signings actually do come with risk because you can't cut them and then go sign another one because those numbers still count towards the hard cap. If you don't have a hard cap, it's great. Just sign and sign and sign until you find the ones that work. I do think Rudy Gay and Carmelo Anthony have the potential to work. I'm a little more sold on Rudy Gay than Carmelo Anthony, but both have the potential to work. And again, it's just about getting shooters and wing defenders, and that's a decent start.
Is there anybody else that would be like high on your list in terms of the veterans that are out there that could realistically sign for a veteran minimum contract?
Veteran minimum, I'm not 100% sure. You know, maybe Wayne Ellington, maybe he's out there for a veteran minimum. I have no idea what his market looks like, but Wayne Ellington's a guy I would certainly think about. Obviously you bring back Caruso and THT and that helps you a little bit there, but there's certainly names out there. And like the reports have said for the last week or so, guys are going to be lining up here to play with this big three because it's such an intriguing team. And it's one of the most entertaining teams we've seen put together in a really long time. So the Lakers will have options.
Especially if you're a shooter, these guys should be blowing up Rob Pelinka's phone right now. Because if you're playing with LeBron, Westbrook, and Anthony Davis, you know the defense is not going to be focused on you at all. You're going to get either a mad dash Russell Westbrook drive to the rim, and he's going to kick it out to you. Teams are going to be trying to deal with LeBron in the post or something like that. He's going to find you. Anthony Davis is going to be getting doubled. He can find you on kickouts. This is a dream come true for anybody who can shoot the ball and is just looking for open looks in order to do that, because those are going to be plentiful.
Also, potentially look for the Lakers to bring back Wesley Matthews. Yeah. There's an opportunity for him to defend on the wing and be a three-point shooter. Look for Danny Green.
Oh, my goodness. Could you imagine, Ron? It's weird. He's actually the perfect fit, isn't he?
Yeah. Time is a flat circle, and Danny Green, all roads lead back to Danny Green in L.A. That'd be something if you could pair Danny and Wes Matthews and Rudy Gay. Let's just get all of the aging veteran 3-and-D wings. Let's just do it. Let's get everyone.
I'm here for it. Yeah, I'd be good with that. Now, Doc Rivers did make some comments about how the 76ers definitely want to keep Danny Green. That was a few weeks ago, right after the 76ers lost in the playoffs. But yeah, so we imagine they want to keep him. I don't know if he'd actually come for the veteran minimum, but maybe taxpayer mid-level. I mean, there's worse ideas out there.
Also, Doc Rivers may have said he wants to keep Danny Green, but when the Lakers got eliminated, they all said they wanted to run it back. And look where we are now. That's out of the question.
That's true. They obviously are not running it back. I will throw one more name out there. This one just hits close to home. Svi Mykhailiuk. Come home, Svi. Just come home. He's a tremendous shooter. He showed a lot of really good skills, especially with the Detroit Pistons. I liked what we saw out of him in summer league when he first debuted with the Lakers. He still has a little bit of upside. I know he's not really a veteran, but come on back, Svi Mykhailiuk. I would love to see that happen.
Yeah, what's the worst that can happen? The Lakers need one of their young core guys back. We traded all of them.
Sorry, I'm sentimental for Svi Mykhailiuk. All right, everybody, let us know what you think. Carmelo Anthony, Rudy Gay, bring them both into the Los Angeles Lakers. Give us your thoughts. Are you here for that? And what do you think about some other targets that the Lakers could look at? Keeping in mind that right now they are laser focused. We know 3 and D. That's what they're looking for. Guys who can hit the three and play some defense to build out this team around the Lakers' new big three. Give us your thoughts in the comments down below. And don't forget, subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel and ring the notification bell as well. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.